Thank you for watching, and in this video I'm gonna cover the slots in the hole wizard tool. So right now, as I am in the features and into the ribbon section, you can see there is an option for hole wizard. So I'm just gonna click the hole wizard, and then into the hole wizard, you know, there are different options. So I'm gonna into the slot, so which is the last row. So I'm just gonna select the counterboard slot or countersunk slot or simple slot, whatever the slot you want to select. So I'm just gonna go with the counterboard slots. And into the standards, you know, like you can choose whatever the standard you want. All the industry standards are here, like NC metric, NC inch, BSI, ISO, whatever the standard you want, you can just choose your standard. Suppose I want to go with the NC metric, and then what kind of slot like you want, so you can choose your type. I want to go with hex bolt. And then under the slot specification, you can choose the size of your slot. So there are different size, because right now we are in metric, so we can see M5, M6, M8, M10. So I would go with the M5, I would say. And then in the fits option, you can check like if you want to have a loose fit, close fit, or normal fit. So normal fit is fine for me. And then next thing is like you can choose the slot length, how long the slot you want to have. So I can reduce it till 20 mm, this is fine. And the last option is end condition. What kind of end condition do you want? So do you want to have a blind end condition through all, up to next vertex, up to next surfaces if you have multiple surfaces, or offset from the surface? So these are the pretty general options which we can see into other tools of the SOLIDWORKS. So I'm gonna go with that through all. And there are some other advanced options, like if you want a head clearance, if you want to go near side of the countersink. So whatever the option you want to choose, you can choose from here. And when you are done with them, what you can do is you can just go into the positions. And then when you are in the position, so you can see wherever you are gonna go and click. If I'm gonna click this surface or this face, so after that this command is gonna be on, and wherever I'm gonna click, I can just click and draw my slot here. But I would like to go into the normal view, so I'm just gonna click the space bar into my keyboard, and then I'm gonna go into this view. And now you can see wherever I'm gonna bring my cursor, so I'm just gonna draw my slot. So what if I want to click here? So this is my first slot, and I want to have another slot here. And right now you are into the command, as you can see, whenever you are coming onto the surface. So you can see the command is on. So if you want to turn off the command, what you can do is you can just press the escape key on your keyboard. And the second option is, as you can see here into the ribbon section, this is a point tool. So you can just click this, so it's gonna be unchecked, and then you are out of the command. And when you are done, you can just select the green check mark, so the slots are gonna be made. But there is another thing which I would like to cover. As you can see, with the first slot there is a center line. So this center line is just to made relations between the first slot and to the other slots. So if I'm gonna select this, so if I want to have a relation between them, I want to change the relation, add relations, as you can see, and there is a relation already which is existing, that is midpoint. And if you want to have another relation, I'm just gonna change it like this. So I'm just adding another relation. So if you don't like, you can just delete the relation from here. And if you are okay, you can just click the green check mark. Or there is another option, like if you want to change the location of this, you can just pick it. You can just pick it from the midpoint, and you can bring it wherever you want. Suppose I want to bring this slot here, so I can bring it here. Or if you want to bring down, you can bring wherever you want. Same into the case of another slot, you can just pick and you can draw wherever you want. Okay, before applying this slot onto this body, there are some other options which I would like to introduce. The first one is, as you can see, like we can apply smart dimensions, and we can give the dimension, we can change the size or whatever you want to have with your slots. And there is another thing, like if you don't want to have these slots, if you don't want to have the position, the horizontal or vertical, you want to have them new positions which is at some specific degree. So what you can do is, as you can see, there is a center line, and the center line have two points. One is left ending point and one is right ending point. So if you want to position this slot on some specific degree, so what you can do is, no matter like right or left point, you can just hold them, and then you can rotate it at whatever degree you want. So in this way we can just rotate the slots, as you can see. Or if you don't like this position, so you can rotate wherever you want. Suppose I want to rotate rotate in this way, or I want to rotate in this way. So in this way I can rotate my slots. This is a really important question which a lot of students are asking, because rotating slots is really important. So in that way you can just point the slots on your exact location wherever you want to point them. So this is the option which I want to mention before applying them. So when you are done with them, so you can do is you can just click the green check mark, and then we can apply these slots onto our 3D, as you can see. So this was all about the slots, and that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SOLIDWORKS learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.